Hi everyone, hope you're doing very well. This is week one of our physical distancing that I think is very required. Please don't take it lightly. There was a video that I saw from one of the health officials in Chicago, which I'll try to post in my feed, which actually talks about just by staying home, how you're saving lives. Nothing is going to happen to you and your family as long as you self-isolate yourself. The unknown here is that whoever you meet may be a carrier and they themselves don't know it. Yes, testing can probably help, but testing takes away a lot of the resources that the health people have. For people who are wondering, like, hey, what's Shashi doing with a jacket on a Saturday morning? I'm actually getting ready to teach a class, my Georgetown class called Search, Social, and Mobile. The hashtag for the class that we're going to use is XCPD732. I had a wonderful group of people. In fact, they felt that the class being kind of a combination of online and flex study was actually much better for them. They could stay home, look after their family, and still attend the class. It's probably going to be the whole day with a break in between. And a lot of things that we should be talking about. But back to the topic that's probably top of mind for all of us is, again, what do we do? It looks like this whole thing is going to take much more than 2 weeks. How do we help out? How do we save ourselves? How do we try to do something? I was reading an interview by Beth Ford. She's the CEO of Lando Lakes. I don't know if many of you knew it. It was very surprising to me as well. That Lando Lakes is actually a farmers cooperative. You think of this like it's like a Fortune 500 company, but that's very interesting. And if you can find her interview on CNN, and I'll try to post that as well, you'll find that one of the categories that is most important to our lives is farmers. We're not talking so much about farmers. Now, when we think about work from home, farmers actually work from home. But they can't take anything virtually. I mean, the science will never ever be able to do something where farmers can sit in front of the computer screen and probably grow stuff, right? So they need help. So I hope everybody is thinking about that as we go into an extended period of self-isolation. Now, I also saw another video. I was trying to ask people if they have some good videos that explain in very simple terms why, right? Like, why do all this? It's important to see that anything that you touch is likely to have the virus. And so if you don't clean your hands after you touch something, you're most likely to spread it to others. And if you're being very like, hey, I don't have it, I don't have any signs, that's exactly the problem with this virus, is that you don't know you have it. Well, on a lighter front, I can see a lot of people posting jokes, which is very good during these days. Sometimes thinking about the positive things. If one of your dreams was to work from home for a long time, hey, your dream came true. Good. So hope you all have a wonderful weekend, and I look forward to conversing with a lot of you. Thank you.